Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Wednesday, the feast of St. Charles Borromeo. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. I will look after my sheep, says the Lord, and I will appoint a shepherd to pasture them, and I, the Lord, will be their God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we offer this Mass, we'd like to remember in a very special way all the souls of the faithful departed, especially those commended to our prayers. We wish to offer this Mass for all of those faithful departed whose names have been given to us. And also we'd like to pray today in a very special way for the founder of ABS, Mr. Henny Lopez. Today is his birth anniversary. So we'd like to remember him, and of course we'd like to remember the ABS-CBN family. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Preserve in the midst of your people, we ask, O Lord, the spirit with which you filled the Bishop St. Charles Borromeo, that your church may be constantly renewed, and by conforming herself to the likeness of Christ, may show his face to the world, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. My beloved, obedient as you have always been, not only when I am present, but all the more now when I am absent, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. For God is the one who, for his good purpose, works in you both to desire and to work. Do everything without grumbling or questioning, that you may be blameless and innocent, children of God, without blemish, in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation, among whom you shine like lights in the world, as you hold on to the word of life, so that my boast for the day of Christ may be that I did not run in vain or labor in vain. But even if I am poured out as a libation upon the sacrificial service of your faith, I rejoice and share my joy with all of you. In the same way, you also should rejoice and share your joy with me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Alleluia, alleluia. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of God rests upon you. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Great crowds were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them. If anyone comes to me without hating his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you, wishing to construct a tower, does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers should laugh at him and say, "This one began to build but did not have the resources to finish." Or what king marching into battle would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, every one of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let me just give a background to today's gospel, and I just want to say one point, and I'd like to talk about actually Saint Charles Borromeo. I think he's a very important saint actually in the life of the Church, and I think more so now, no, during this time. No? First of all, the gospel for today, it actually sees make us see Christ preparing the people for his entry, his going to Jerusalem. No, if you notice, you know, Christ addressed the crowds and told them, in a sense, predicted his passion, that whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Because as we mentioned last week, no, and at the beginning of this week, Christ was beginning to see clearly now that he was on his way to Jerusalem where he will die to fulfill his mission. And remember, again, there was this whole misunderstanding during the time wherein some of the followers of Christ were expecting a powerful Messiah, no, someone who will build an empire in order to establish God's kingdom. So Christ is again correcting that misconception. He's trying to make people understand that his kingdom is not the powerful earthly kingdom, but it will be that he will achieve his mission through the cross and resurrection. So I think that is one of the main points that we can reflect on in today's gospel. But let me invite you to reflect more on Charles Borromeo. So Charles Borromeo was a 16th century bishop, no? And he was one of the leading lights in the Counter-Reformation. You have Charles Borromeo, Philip Neri, and of course, Ignatius of Loyola. They were the three leading figures of the Counter-Reformation. Kung matatandaan natin nung panahon na yon, dyan lumabas yung Protestant Church, yung tinatawag na Reformation Movement. Sila Luther, sila Calvin, and that was a very strong movement during that time in the church, yung Protestant movement. Kasi inaano nila, pinotestan nila yung pag-aabuso ng simbahan, lalo-lalo na yung parang pagbebenta ng mga grasya, no? So maraming iba't ibang mga kakulangan ng simbahan na kanilang binabatikos, no, ng Protestant movement. At dyan nagkaroon ng unang malaking pagkahati ng simbahan. At yan ay ang tinatawag na Reformation Movement. Then you have the Counter-Reformation, which is a movement within the Church to counter the Reformation Movement, but also to institute certain, you might say, reforms within the Church. And Charles Borromeo is one of the leading figures of the Counter-Reformation. So kung merong Reformation Movement yung mga Protestante, sa loob naman ng simbahan meron tinatawag na Counter-Reformation, na sila yung maraming mga pagbabago at pagsasaayos sa simbahan ang ginawa nila. Si Charles Borromeo, yung kapistahan niya ngayon, isa sa mga taong nagtulak na higit na mapabuti ang pag-aaral at ang paghubog sa mga pare. So he was very, very strong in terms of reforming the formation and the education of the priests at that time, because he saw very well that part of the problem that caused the Reformation movement were the priests who were not very well educated and well formed, so which caused a lot of scandal within the church during the 16th century. And Charles Borromeo was known to be a very holy man and a very strong and charismatic leader, no? And the reason why I want to reflect on him is I think, no, now we need leaders like that, especially within the church also, no, not just in our government but also within the church. I think in a sense ang simbahan ngayon ay nangingilatis eh. Kumbaga tayo ay we are discerning ano ba ang kahulugan ng pagiging komunidad, pagiging simbahan, lalong-lalo na dito sa sitwasyon ng pandemya at yung sinatawag natin na new normal. Di ba habang tumatagal, nakikita natin na hindi tayo magbabalik dun sa nakagawian natin na mapupuno ang simbahan, pwede tayong bumalik sa pagsisimba at pagkakaroon ng mga meetings, mga prayer meetings, etc. Sabi nga nila, di ba, kahit sa Amerika na maraming pera at lahat ng research nangyayari, hindi magno-normalize until 2022, no? At yan ay sa Amerika, no? Hindi natin alam sa atin kung gano'ng katagal na tatagal pa. Kaya pala ikaw mahalaga na bilang isang simbahan ay tayo ay magdasal na, no? At mag-discern what does it mean to be church now, no? Given the limitations that we have. We cannot gather and congregate. And I think this will go on for maybe what, another year or maybe even 2 years. And even then, after that, you know, we cannot wait for 2 years to do something, no? But now we must begin to discern what it means to be church. And I think there, you know, it is a chance for us to really, in a sense, reform the church and to build it into a church that is really, number one, more a church for the poor and for us to build it together, not just like that we will act something like a charitable NGO. No, but we are a community that we must together build the new church that is needed for the future. And I think most certainly nakita naman natin itong pandemyan to na kailangan makiisa ang simbahan sa maraming tao na naghihirap, sa maraming tao na walang makain dahil walang trabaho. Napalagay ko ito isa sa mga mahalagang masasabi natin pagbabago at pagmumuling pag-inspirasyon ng simbahan na sa kalagitnaan nitong pandemyan to ay tayo magkaroon ng inspirasyon na maging simbahan para sa mga, lalo na sa mga nagdurus. Sabi nga ng PCP2, to be church for the poor. But if I may add, to be church for the poor together. Together, to build this church together and most especially to take really the side of the suffering and the poor. And today we pray for that. We pray on the feast of one of the great reformers of the church, St. Charles Borromeo, that the Lord may raise leaders within our church who will truly champion the rebuilding of our church amidst this time of crisis and pandemic, to become a church that will welcome everybody, to become a church that will give hope and inspiration to people, and especially to come out of this crisis a much better community, a much better church, a much better human family. Hilingin natin na tayo ay higit na maging mabuting komunidad, maging mabuting simbahan, maging mabuting bansa at lipunan, at maging mabuting pamilya ng mga kapwa-tao, di ba? Pakikipagkapwa-tao. And today, let us ask the Lord to bless us with leaders who will truly give us inspiration to build a better future and a better world and a better church. In the name of the Father and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us come to God the Father that we may follow Christ consistently and be able to respond to the demands of discipleship. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Pope, the bishops, and priests may continue to show forth true discipleship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may lay aside trust in material possessions and find our true strength in God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may not turn our back on suffering, but may accept the crosses that come our way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that those who carry crosses of physical, mental, or spiritual anguish may learn to walk in the footsteps of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our deceased relatives, especially those who have moved on due to the virus, who have carried Christ's cross in this world, may now enjoy eternal happiness in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And today again, let us pray specially for the founder of ABS, Mr. Henny Lopez. And let us also pray for ABS. And of course, we pray for all the souls of the faithful departed, most especially those who have been commended to our prayers during our daily masses. And so together now, let us offer our prayer for the souls of the faithful departed.
Prayer for the faithful departed. This month of All Souls, we remember all our family and friends who have gone ahead of us. We pray for all the souls in purgatory. Grant them, Father, eternal rest together with you, our risen Lord, the Spirit of Life, our Blessed Mother, and all the saints. May we always remember them in our prayers. We ask that they too pray for us, all our families and friends, who continue our journey here on earth. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look, O Lord, upon the offering placed on your altar in commemoration of Saint Charles, and grant by the power of this sacrifice that as you made him an attentive pastor, outstanding in the merit of his virtues, so you may make us abound in good fruit by our works, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Charles you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teacher by his words of preaching, and keeper safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, as we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, and God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember Henny, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who shared in the death of Christ may also share in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with St. Charles Borromeo, with apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray, Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
Let us pray. May the sacred mysteries of which we have partaken, O Lord, we pray, give us that determination which made Saint Charles faithful in ministry and fervent in charity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.